Hello, Hermione. Do you recognise this potion?
I'm surprised you don't recognise it, seeing as you're top in potions. It's obvious what this is.
So, what is it?
Why ask me? You should ask the Half-Blood Prince.
All right, I will. Well, I can make the potion and find out anyway. Shredded boomslang skin. Take one boomslang skin, dry until dry, then shred. Stewed lacewing flies. I don't think that's going to get me an outstanding. Fluxwing.
Back again, are we, Harry? And a splendid polyjuice potion you're making. But I do hope you're not intending to take it. It is a restricted potion.
You're sure it's polyjuice, sir?
Of course, that grey and sludgy finish, all characteristic. But then you should know, my lad, you made it.
I was just experimenting. Thanks, sir. Polyjuice potion? You use that if you want to look like someone else. I wonder what Malfoy would want with that.
Voldemort? Isn't going to trust Malfoy with a mission. You haven't got a scrap of evidence, have you?
No, not yet. But I'll get something.
Dumbledore wants you to go to his office for another lesson. Harry, when you see Dumbledore, don't say anything about Malfoy.
He's up to something. He's sneaking around and he's even ditched Crabbe and Goyle.
Yes, I admit that is out of character. But you don't have evidence that he's doing anything.
If he's not, then why is he sneaking around the seventh floor and... The seventh floor? That's it! He's using the Room of Requirement! That's why he keeps disappearing off the Marauder's map.
Well, if he is using the room, you won't be able to see what he's doing in there. That's why we used it for DA meetings. Concentrate on your lesson with Dumbledore. He's waiting for you in his office.
Hi, Harry. Are you here to see Professor Dumbledore? I am too.
Are you all right? Come on, what's the matter?
It's silly. A Slytherin stole my gobstone. It's a noisy hitter my mum got me for Christmas.
Who was it?
Him.
Wait here. I'll get your gobstone back. Hey, did you take a noisy hitter from the girl over there?
What's it got to do with you?
Give it back.
What are you going to do? Jinx me? I'm sure Professor Snape would love to know you've been jinxing Slytherins. He might even give you detention.
Stupefy! Expelliarmus! Stupefy! Dango! There! Now hand over that noisy hitter.
I hope it gobs all over you.
And next time, think twice before you bully someone. Here you are.
Thanks! Harry, you're the best!
Acid Pops.
Good evening, Harry.
Professor, about Malfoy and... Snape.
Professor Snape. I've told you, Harry, I trust Severus. My answer has not changed. Now, to the business at hand. I have not been able to find many memories of Tom Riddle at Hogwarts. I did, however, find this one.
Good gracious, look at the time. Off you go, boys. Lestrange, Avery, don't forget your essays. Look sharp there, Tom. No, Tom, I don't know anything about Horcruxes. And I wouldn't tell you if I did. Now get out of here.
I don't understand. What happened?
Professor Slughorn has tampered with his memory. Harry, I asked you to get to know Professor Slughorn. Now, I want you to persuade him to divulge his true memory. Any way you can. That memory is everything. But I believe you have Quidditch practice. You'll find your way there more easily now the orders have opened more of the castle. Good day, Harry.
I solemnly swear that I am up to no good. Mischief managed.
Hello, Harry. Professor McGonagall's looking for you.
Do you know what she wants?
No, but she's waiting for you in the Transfiguration courtyard. Sounded important. We really should go and see McGonagall. She was rather insistent. We really should go and see McGonagall. She was rather insistent. I've been doing some research. I went to the library. I checked in the restricted. And I couldn't find anything on this half-blood prince. There's nothing to say who this person is.
Good. Then they can't be that bad.
We really should go and see McGonagall. She was rather insistent. We really should go and see McGonagall. She was rather insistent. We really should go and see McGonagall. She was rather insistent.
Ah, there you are. I wanted to talk to you after the unfortunate events at the Burrow over Christmas. Why is it always you? When something happens?
Believe me, Professor. I've been asking myself that for years.
I heard you've joined the dueling club, Harry. I think you should follow his example, and the Weasleys too. You can't be too prepared. Don't limit yourself to your friends in Gryffindor, mind. Ah. Here's the person we were waiting for.
Hi, Harry.
Alanis here is captain of the Ravenclaw Dueling Club. You come along with me, Miss Granger, and we'll sign you up with Gryffindor Dueling Club.
Would you like to practice casting Levy Corpus with us? I've always wanted to learn that spell.
Okay.
Levy Corpus!
Thanks for teaching us that. Be careful though, you might find some Ravenclaws casting at you in future duels. Let's try a proper duel while you're here. Ravenclaw's junior champion against Harry Potter.
Thank you.
Harry. As a special member's privilege, you can use that portrait shortcut over there. The password is light against darkness. Why don't you try our dueling challenge? Just go to the notice board when you're ready to give it a go.
I believe you're due at a Quidditch training session. I am rather hoping Gryffindor will win the Quidditch Cup this year. Get yourself along there, Potter. Great Quidditch teams are not built on tardiness.
Light against darkness.
Keep up the good fight!
Nick?
Miss Ginny Weasley is waiting with the rest of your team down at the Quidditch pitch.
I would hurry along and join them if I were you.
Boiled beetles.
Ah, they're everywhere.
Incendio! Splendio!
Harry.
Where is everyone?
They're already out practicing.
Great. Can you help me with some seeker practice?